Honoured guests, Michael Denby, MP, Federal Member for Melbourne Ports, David Southwick, MP, State Member for Caulfield, Councillor Jamie Hines, Mayor of the City of Glenira, Nina Bassett, AM, President of Jewish Community Council of Victoria, Vivian Brass, President, National Council of Jewish Women, Rebecca Forgash, Director, Jewish Museum of Australia, Pauline Rockman, OIM, President, Jewish Holocaust Museum, Warren Feinberg, Executive Director, Jewish Holocaust Museum, Sam Tatarka, President, Zionist Council of Victoria, Michael Zilberman, President of the Bund, Helen Greenberg, Principal, Shalom Aleichem College, Kadimah, Honorary Solicitor, Harry Smirling. Welcome, dear VIPs and friends, and members of the Kadimah, Shalom, Shalom Aleichem, of the 100th anniversary of the establishment of our esteemed organization, the Jewish Cultural Center and National Library, Kadimah. At the outset, I would like to acknowledge and honor the traditional owners of the land upon which we find ourselves, its custodians, past and present. As we pride ourselves in being the custodians of the Yiddish language and culture in Australia, it is proper that I deliver my introduction in both languages. Those of you who are bilingual will unfortunately have to hear my speech twice, but I ask for your patience and indulgence, in you in particular. Husha the guest, Tayyar Elikvinot of the Kadimah, Shalom and Shalom Aleichem. Es ist mein größer Kovet und Vergnügen zu begrüßen euch zu der Feierung vom 100. Jubel von der Entstehung von unserer Kultur Organisation, der Jiddische Kulturzentrum und Nationale Bibliothek Kadimah. Wenn die 80 Mitglieder Gründer von der Kadimah mit dem Präsident Yehusha Rochlin Barosch vom beschlossen zu gründen die Institution am 26. Dezember 1911 und bestimmt anzurufen seine neue Bibliothek auf dem hebräisch-jüdischen Namen, was meint und bedeutet für uns Progress, haben sie sich sicher nicht vorgestellt, als die Organisation wird existieren noch mit 100 Jahren später. Wie weit und wie äußerlich hat sich die Welt geändert, bemächtigt von die 100 Jahren. When the 80-odd members, founders of the Kadimah, led by the first president Yehoshua Rochlin, settled on that name, which in Hebrew and Yiddish means forward and progress, they would surely have never thought that it would still be going 100 years later. How much and how unbelievably the world has changed during the past 100 years. And yet, as they say, the more things change, the more things remain the same. The Kadimah is no longer located just a dropkick from the Victorian Parliament at 59 Bourke Street, having journeyed from there through Carlton to Elsternwick with the shifting of the community which it serves. The membership numbers at the Kadimah have waxed and waned and currently resemble those of the early decades. The library, the mainstay of the organisation, has grown from no books at all in 1912, just 20 newspapers and journals, to a 40,000 plus unique treasure trove of mainly Yiddish books and publications, the biggest such collection, we think, in the Southern Hemisphere. Soon it will locate part of that collection at the Lamb Jewish Library of Australia, which coincidentally was open this morning, and we wish them a hearty mazel tov and a yesher koyach. Nach die 100 Jahre seien aber so etliche Ähnlichkeiten zu dir.
Their names, which will be done soon, we didn't have time to do it, is Namen von dem Komitee und alle Mitglieder von der Kadimah, will ich übergeben Alex einen größten Dank für alle Arbeit, was er bis jetzt getan und sie dort zweimal so viel noch ein.
Das letzte ist 100% Hemmes. Der Arbeit endigt sich nicht. And now I would like to call on some of our honored guests to greet us on this joy.
They said Mel Torme was the velvet fog. So he's the Yiddish version of the Velvet Fog on SBS Radio and emceeing today. It's a great honour to be here. All of the historical metamorphosis of the Kadimah is in the booklet and in his excellent short historical speech. I'm sure people know the ins and outs here much better than I do. I've only been around this place since the early 80s, well, this Kadimah, this incarnation. There are many memorable evenings that I've come here to. First of all, I remember the pictures were over there. They've been moved, I understand, so you can rent the building to theatrical groups, you can put the curtains, and then people won't see the old members of the Central Committee on the wall. I once got the former great Kadimah person, Yasha Sher, once showed me an envelope that he got, which was addressed to Yasser, Y-A-S-S-E-R, like Yasser Arafat, at the Jewish Board of Works. You've got to know these people. Bono Wiener, another giant who strode through here. I used to discuss, like an entomologist with him, the 50 varieties of Trotskyism. Only he would know it in such great detail. The first time I came here was at a platform with Senator John Button. And many leading public figures in Australian life have known this building and have come here for public meetings. And the Kadimah is part not just of the Jewish community's life, but of Australian public life. We had at the time the representative of the Histadrut, Michael Zeef, at the on the platform. And I come here regularly now with Tommy and many of the artists for the Wednesday Club, and I can't speak highly enough of my old friends Abram and Sesha Goldberg for the work they do with older people. I remember them as restaurateurs in Goldies, like many of you do, back in the city. When I was a university student, I used to go there. It was knuckers to go and get some Jewish food in the, after being at uni all day. And I can remember Sesha with a huge silver tray of schnitzels running backwards and forwards to Frank Thring, who would sit at the back of the restaurant, which is behind the Athenaeum, in a huge black coat and a black polo neck and a silver amulet and black glasses, straight from the Quo Vadis or Ben-Hur or many of the other movies that he'd, Sword and Sandals movies that he'd starred in. So it's the people who are here are what make Kadimah. And I was looking on the wall there, I can't see Sokolovich. So I hope no one's been purged from the wall, because I notice you've got one mistake, if I'm following the traditions of Bono. It's not the Slonsky trials, it's the Slansky trials. All the Jews who were members of the Communist Party of the Czech Republic, who fought in the international brigades in Spain, as you know, were purged for being Zionists by Stalin and by the committee. It's fantastic that people associated with the Jewish community of all the places in the world, including in public meetings here, remembered all of these events, stood for Jewish solidarity, Jewish culture, and as I say again, I can't praise the work of this organisation enough. And the central of the people who bought this building, how did they know that the classic cinema would be such a success? How could they have predicted it? When I went there, when I was a youngster, there was a one man with a white shirt and a black bow tie, and the audiences were going down and down and down and down. And thank heavens you sold it to Tamir, and he's now got... So when I go to the cinema last night, I can't even get in to the margin call because it's absolutely packed out every seat. So, kol hakavod to Kadimah for all its wonderful work, for the continual strong presence you provide for Jewish culture and respect for our elders and our traditions that this community is known for, and for the name that you have in the wider, good name that you have in the wider general community.
Firstly, to my parliamentary colleague Michael Danby, to Mayor Jamie Hines, to you, Alex, in the wonderful work that you have done, and all of your committee members. We've heard already the tireless work that you have put into Kadimah, and it is terrific that somebody like yourself takes on a role. We all know that the President's job is a hard job, but for you to put yourself in year in, year out to contribute the way that you have done, I think we should wish you a hearty mazel tov on the work that you've done. It's my pleasure to be with you all here this afternoon, and I bring good wishes from both the Premier and the Minister for Multicultural Affairs, Nick Katsiris, who especially wanted to reiterate the great work that Kadimah does, the work that is cherished as a real model of multiculturalism here in the heart in Caulfield. And many of you were here, were at the land opening this morning, at the library opening, where the Premier actually called this area, be it Caulfield, be it Elsternwick, as the heart of multiculturalism. And I thought that was terrific that that we have been identified as truly a centre of activity that accepts all, that cherishes multiculturalism and enhances multiculturalism and champions it. And for many of you that have come from different countries, from Far East Europe, from Russia, and settled here, and have contributed in your own lives, and have not only contributed personally in your families, but also what you've done for Victoria and for the wider community is certainly is to be cherished and is to be promoted, because this is truly a fantastic model. And in terms of the work that you do, and I know we've mentioned Shesha and Avram, who have been recognised as citizens of the of Glen Ira in the work that they do, not just for Kadimah but for the broader work, and I think we should wish them once again a mazel tov for the contribution. And Alex mentioned that I'm fairly new. I'm certainly of 15 months as the member for Caulfield, and I know prior to that Helen, the former member, was great supporter. I have had the opportunity to come to a number of Wednesday clubs and speak to the groups, and I've really enjoyed that. And in fact, the last time that I came here, I spoke of my family who had discovered many lost survivors only through a visit to Hungary and visiting a grave site, and then at the grave site wanting to understand who was keeping that grave site alive, only to discover whole families that they didn't realise existed. History is just so important, and tradition is so important. The fact that we have many people that have struggled, that have survived atrocities, that are here today, we have younger generations that are with them here today as well. But it is also important to call out to even younger generations again to ensure that history is never repeated, and to ensure that traditions are passed on. And that's why the Kadimah Library component, and I've mentioned the cultural component, but the library component is so important. The library centre that we mentioned this morning is very important. I see Rebecca here with the museum. All of these things of that are just really absolute imperative to ensure our younger generations are educated, that we learn, that we never forget, and that we enhance learning in any possible way. Once again, if I could just congratulate you all on today. 100 years is a big effort for anybody to reach a 100-year milestone, and it must have been the email from the Queen, not the telegraph, because we're probably advancing since. But it's great that we've been able to receive that sort of recognition. Congratulations on 100 years, and may it be many, many more years of success ahead for Kadimah. Mazel tov.
Alex Daphne, members of the Kadimah Committee and all the volunteers, members of Parliament, Michael Danby, David Southwick, President of the JCCB, Nina Bassett, other distinguished guests, including former Councillor of Glen Ira, Henry Buck. It gives me great pleasure to be here today at this auspicious event to congratulate the Jewish Centre and National Library of Kadimah on 100 years of distinguished service not just to the Jewish community, but to the wider community as well. Alex, who I see looking through the booklet, has been president for the last 17 years out of that 100, which is a fantastic effort when you consider there have been 34 presidential terms and one man has done it for a sixth of that time. I think that's a fantastic effort, so I think that's amazing. And Alex was kind enough to provide me with a history of the Kadimah organisation. And it was very interesting to see how in many ways it actually mirrored the history of the Jewish community in Melbourne, starting in the city itself, then moving to Carlton, before coming here to Glenora, which is now the municipality with the most Jewish residents of any in Australia. And I see that while numbers may have dropped since the heyday in the 1950s, the Kadimah is still a very, very valued group in the Glenora community. And there's no better illustration of this than the fact that you won the award for the Glenora Community Group of the Year in 2008. And as was mentioned, Mr. Goldberg, who's just sitting down, he was also our Citizen of the Year a couple of years later for his work at the Holocaust Museum, but also in the Kadimah. There were well over 300 community groups in Glenora that were eligible for that award. So it really is a significant achievement and it was very well deserved. And we're also regularly pleased to see Kadimah volunteers awarded for their service on our volunteer recognition nights. And as we are the level of government closest to the community council, and councillors are particularly aware of the massive contribution to our community of volunteer-based organisations such as Kadimah, Glenora would be immeasurably poorer without the work you do. And a special concern of our council is maintaining social connectedness and promoting community involvement. It's very easy for people as they become a bit older and perhaps don't speak English as a first language to become socially isolated. So groups such as Kadimah with the Wednesday Club and other initiatives play a very crucial role in preventing this happening to many people, which is a truly valuable service. And of course, you're a vital organisation in Australia for keeping alive the Yiddish language and culture, which have contributed so much, not just to the Jewish community, but for the to the wider community as well, for all your many activities, the library, which was mentioned, and was this morning at Beth Weitzman, and through the artistic and cultural events, which also greatly enriched the cultural feeling for the whole of the community. Organisations such as yours make a major contribution to the multiculturalism, which is such an important feature of Australian society. And it's also seen by the fact that you won the Victorian Multicultural Award for Excellence in 2008. But in a world that changes as quickly as ours, it's important not just to remember where we came from, but to try to keep the best parts of that history alive. And that's what you do here. So I'm very pleased to have this opportunity today to congratulate and thank Alex and the committee and all the volunteers for the great work that you do. So keep up the good work, and I'm sure the Kadimah will continue to flourish for another 100 years. Thank you.
Mr. Alex Gaffner, distinguished guests and friends. Mama Loshin, the mother tongue of many of Melbourne's Ashkenazi Jews, has not survived, not only survived, but still flourishes, is one of the miracles of this community. And it's a miracle which is in very large measure attributable to Kadimah. From Burke Street, as you've heard, to Carlton. Better? Okay. Yes. I'm not very tall. From Burke Street to Carlton to Elsternwick, as you've already heard, each geographic movement has not only survived, it has grown. From Skiff to Habonim, it has housed movements of disparate philosophy, and I do still remember those Habonim days. From cultural lectures to political debates, from protests and solidarity meetings to dances, from Yiddish theatre to national library, from music to social clubs, Kadimah, as you have already heard, has covered and continues to cover a wide spectrum of activities, and it has been for 100 years the hub of Jewish Yiddish life. That's it. That's where the Yiddish life has been and continues to be. It has forged lifelong friendships and created social cohesion. And above all, it has promoted and encouraged the continuing use and love of the Yiddish language. During those 100 years, interestingly enough, Kadimah has exerted on our community an influence way beyond its size and membership.
Given Kadimah was established in Carlton, once it's moved from the city, we thought it was very fitting to begin this set with a look towards Carlton, and we are going to sing a song written by Julie Meadows, who's sitting over here on this table. It's called A Shtetl in Eckveld, and This is her song about Carlton. Sis da Wind was blost weg die Jahren. Zeit der Wind is was blost jede Sache weg. Die Tag, die Nacht, die Kerl, die gelbe Blätter. Verschwinden sie und kommen nicht zurück. Die Tag, die Nacht, die Kerl, die gelbe Blätter. Verschwinden sie und kommen nicht zurück. Städtele verblieben, a Städtele geschaffen in Eckwelt. Aus das, was sie ist geblieben in Sekunden, a Neuzer, was ist teiere von Geld. Bloß das, was sie ist. That the arrangement is David Kreiser's. Yeah. However, when I did mention that Julie wrote the song, she didn't just write this.
Ganz ich genau. von Greisig Les, up and gets von Kenalev. Everybody was drinking from long tall glasses. Lech habe dem Hassen, und lech habe der Kaleinon, the bride and groom. Durch Maschke hat der Zatte Mann genommen, durch Maschke bin ich auf der Welt gekommen.
Australian rules, which only us old enough to remember that term will know what it means. So Tesha, can be give the river them covet. Ruchel, that's healthy a bit. Tesha good gesagt, dass der Kuchen zu groß.
Dein Geburtstag ist heim.
Bravo,
traditionell, weil wir singen das scheine jüdische Begrüßung Lomina.
A Vegemite color, a foreign mental, or a flesh color.
Fahr aus, fahr so. Shelby Hall.
Aber Egil Becker wird Prime Minister.
Zu machen, Mama Jontek ist nicht schwer.
Na, frag ich bei euch. Hey, grobe Jung, was kennt kein Sach? Entfernt er mir mit der